this has really thrown a wrench into the operation here. We had a whole schedule, and now it's all changed.
Hey, you know, variety is the spice of life, Jim.
Well, let's go to Caleb Willis with the official introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is for the AIWF World Title. Introducing first, the challenger, weighing today at 200 pounds, from Plano, Williams, he is the baddest man alive, Aaron Williams!
Aaron Williams, the baddest man alive, self-proclaimed. There's no real way to prove that.
Do you think you're better than him?
Absolutely not.
Are you living?
Yes.
There's two great reasons why he can probably claim that.
And the fans go absolutely ballistic for Eric Darkstore.
He is beloved here in the arena.
Here at the ICS Arena, ICS 7, Agent Orange, kicking off with a bang. Fans are getting the Dark Storm chant ready. It's gonna start sweeping around the arena. Soon enough, we won't even be able to hear ourselves commentate.
That'll be good for me.
This is for all the marbles.
Actually, just half of them if you're Dark Storm, but still.
Well, yeah, this is for some marbles. We're getting some marbles out of this.
For exactly 50% of the marbles that Dark Storm brought to the ring, metaphorically.
Already, the fans are at a fever pitch, and there's the bell. We are underway. International Combat Sports 7, Agent Orange. Two men filling each other out.
It's a very, very good dynamic we have going here. It is the champion, Eric Darkstorm, versus the store manager, Aaron Williams. Really a fan of the way Aaron Williams has decided to dress for combat. For Christ's sake, he's got a belt on.
Well, he's a regional manager.
Yeah.
And he backs Eric Darkstorm into the corner. Darkstorm reverses. Could we get a clean break here?
Nathan Darkstorm. Wolf on it tonight.
Darkstorm
right out
with
the gate.
Clean break. Aaron Williams complaining. Seems to be in his nature. Once again, filling each other out. Carl Arnobo tie up.
Darkstorm seems to have a little extra giddy up in his step today. Maybe we should put Darkstorm's matches on first every time.
Well, he's
raring to go. Usually at the end of the night.
Oh, semi-clean break. Darkstorm says, "I will not pay a lot for that muffler."
That is just flat disrespectful right there.
Aaron Williams takes a powder outside the ring. Darkstorm's trying to get the crowd involved, and the crowd acquiesces.
Good word usage.
Yes. I know words. Nathan Wolf with the count. Aaron Williams re-enters the ring, the fighting arena, the squared circle, if you will. Another collar and elbow tie-up. Duck under, rear waist lock.
Williams trying to break it in. There we go, a little reversal action.
Turnabout is fair play. Reach through, ducks back under. Another reversal. A little bit of a stalemate going on now.
Darkstorm looks like he kind of grabbed the hair there. Aaron Williams thought
what
ahead.
What are you talking about?
Aaron Williams thought ahead of that. Shaved his head 5 years ago.
I'm not sure if it was a choice.
Well, we're all in that same boat right now.
I don't know what you're talking about. I have lovely long locks, just much akin to Eric Darkstorm.
Flowing blonde locks here.
Another collar number type. Duck under by Williams. Rear waist lock. Reversal by Darkstorm. Headlock.
If nothing else, they are two definite wrestling technicians.
Very evenly matched, right around the same size.
But both equally putting on a clinic right now in what they know and what they can do. I'm interested to see who and how an advantage is going to take place here.
Seemed to be a little bit apprehensive. Could we get a test of strength?
Could be.
Definitely be evenly matched in this area. They lock up. Oh, and he slaps him right across the mouth. It must have been a fly on his face or something.
Yeah, he's a compassionate guy.
Low kick. I've seen those leg kicks destroy men. Leg sweep. He sweeped the leg, Johnny. Oh, and he misses the elbow. Action too quick to call. Roll up. Rolls out of the roll up. Off the ropes.
Into it. Down. Over. Leapfrog. Oh,
right
there. Good
Lord. Sometimes there are accidents that are good, and sometimes they're bad.
Darkstorm with a slap of his own now. I spoke earlier about who's going to get an advantage and when it would happen. For a moment, I thought it might happen in that exchange there, but I don't think it did. I think they're still pretty evenly matched here.
Yeah, nobody has a clear advantage in this one. Williams throws Darkstorm outside the ring to the apron. Darkstorm inside, outside. Sunset flip doesn't work. Tries to take him down to a Fujiwara armbar, perhaps.
Yep, foot on the ropes, foot on the ropes. Break it there, Darkstorm.
Nathan Wolf with the count. Best referee in the business.
Absolutely.
Darkstorm did not want to let go of that crossface. Aaron Williams outside the ring. Oh, basement dropkick. Aaron Williams into the front row.
Took a seat right there amongst those passionate fans. Good little rest for him, and I'd just sit there and wait it out, really.
Well, he wants to win the title, and you can't win the title if you lose by a countout. Darkstorm off the ropes. Aaron Williams back in, ducks the clothesline. Whoa. Oh, good Lord almighty. Drapes his face across the ropes. Goes for the cover. One, two, kick out of two and a half.
That was nasty.
That was brutal.
That is.
Darkstorm showing a little bit of a nasty side.
Action's getting hard and heavy fast here right off the bat in ICS. Just the way we like it, baby.
Aaron Williams in the corner. Darkstorm picks him up. European uppercut. Oh, what a big chop across the chest.
Can hear that all the way in Charleston.
Oh,
another one.
Another big chop. You can hear that one all the way in cross lanes. Darkstorm seems to be playing a little dirty.
Is it dirty or is it just extra aggressive? Because as we mentioned earlier, these guys are two evenly matched competitors.
They don't seem to like each other. Out of the corner, into the other corner, right across the ring.
Right,
so powerful. So powerful, he drops him. There's a face plant. Now he's face wash into the corner. Darkstorm definitely showing a little bit of a darker side. Off the ropes. Goes for the kick. Misses. Oh!
Right in the side of the head.
Tilt-a-whirl forearm. Darkstorm's got some cobwebs in his brain now.
That put the brakes on everything Eric was trying to accomplish.
Aaron Williams stomping the living hell out of Eric Darkstorm. Darkstorm's down, but he's not out of it. Aaron Williams trying to think of what he can do to put him away. So he stands on his throat. I like it.
Can't fight if you can't breathe.
And Aaron Williams seems to be unbuttoning his shirt.
He's taking us to the complaint department. That's what he's doing. One,
two, three. Nathan Wolf losing his mind about Aaron Williams shoving Darkstorm's face into that turnbuckle.
Well, he's distracted by that manly physique he started revealing there, apparently.
Williams picks Darkstorm up. Big chop to the chest.
Got some chops of his own there, just as loud as Eric's were earlier.
Everybody loves a chop. You hear the fans react to every single one of them. Off the ropes, big kick to the face.
Right in the mush.
Goes for the cover. One, two, two and a half.
So
Darkstorm
close.
Kicks out.
So close. He's definitely got to stay on him, though.
Aaron Williams seems to be taking his time, very methodical in his approach.
Yeah, I don't know if that's the best strategy.
His head is shining like the sun. I love it.
Yeah, see, that's.
He's got him while he's got his sleeves still around his arms. Darkstorm taking advantage. Williams falls out of the damn ring.
On his
all the
head.
Way out to the floor. Fans in the front row getting up close and personal with Aaron Williams. Darkstorm seems to be regrouping in the ring. He's going to join him for a dance on the outside.
What do you think they're going to dance?
It's a metaphor, Bronk.
Oh, all right.
Darkstorm picks up Williams. Whoa! As the sound echoes through the ICS arena from the big chops of Eric Darkstorm. Oh, good Lord. He's going to break his damn sternum, Bronco.
Might break his own hand hitting that hard. You see Eric Darstorm trying to wave it off.
Oh, and he trips over the chair.
In the back of the head there.
Very intelligent move by Aaron Williams.
Williams got now that advantage back.
That poor fan doesn't have a chair now. What's he going to do?
Well, I mean, being upright is probably good for him. You know, it's...
Williams breaks the count. Oh, and he replaces the chair, puts it back in his place.
What a gentleman. What a gentleman Aaron Williams
What
is.
A gentleman.
There you are, sir. Appreciate your help.
Aaron Williams measuring Darkstorm. Oh, good Lord, connected with a right cross right across the jaw of Eric Darkstorm. Action's going back into the ring.
What I'm really concerned about here is I just hope that somebody gets Mr. Williams' shirt back. That's a nice shirt.
That's a $70 shirt. I believe he got it from Macy's.
That's $70. That's more than some of these people in this room spend on food every month.
You're not wrong about that, Bronk. Williams trying to zap the energy out of Darkstorm with a rear chin lock. Trying to cut off the carotid artery. Darkstorm is fighting back. No! All for nothing as he gets the back of his head slammed to the mat. And as you know, that ring is unforgiving.
Absolutely. I forgot the ring's birthday 2 years ago. Still won't talk to me. Still won't talk to me.
Williams picks up Darkstorm, takes him to the center of the ring. Big body slam.
This could be it here. We don't know where he goes. Yeah,
he's going up to the top rope.
The high-risk district, as you call it.
It's high risk, high reward. If he connects,
that's right.
This could be the end of the match, and he could be the new AIWF champion. Let's see how it folds, how it unfolds. Big frog splash.
Hey,
good
right
Lord,
here.
This is it. Darkstorm, one,
two, three. Oh.
Darkstorm kicks out.
I'm amazed.
Summoned power from somewhere and was able to break up the count at 2.5.
Yeah, I don't see how. I mean, the height he got and the impact he had, just sheer tenacity out of Darkstorm to kick out of that. Really.
Williams is beside himself. He cannot believe Darkstorm kicked out. Could he be thinking about going back up to the top?
Might want to put a little extra offense in if he's going to climb again, you know.
Yeah, Darkstorm has an ability to recover very quickly.
Yeah, he's definitely a resilient gentleman.
That's his middle name.
Is it Resilient Eric?
Eric Resilient Darkstorm.
Oh, a Resilient Gentleman, what I was going with. Okay, cool.
That would have been funnier.
ERGD.
Williams has him in the corner, and he's just stomping him. He's got his head draped on the outside of the ring across the apron. What's he going to do? Oh, big double axe handle right across his head. Williams needs to get back in the ring and put together a pinning combination of some sort.
Yeah, because even though he's on the offensive every time.
Choking him in the corner. There's some offense for you, Bronk.
Yeah, you see, he gets on the offensive, but you watch when he gets off, you can see Darkstorm's kind of shaking and trying to rally a little bit. He knows. He gets a little bit of a breather there. He's going to bring it back just like he always does.
Choking him again. He breaks the count at 3.
Nathan Wolf is on his game today, not taking any chances.
Nathan Wolf suffers no fools.
That's right.
He came here to referee a damn wrestling match.
That is law and order as it stands.
Darkstorm with a kick out of the corner. Somehow he's fighting back.
See, I told you.
And another choke into the corner. Aaron Williams is having none of it. Nathan Wolf breaking. Oh! Aaron Williams shoves Nathan Wolf. Oh! Oh! Nathan Wolf with the power from hell shoving Aaron Williams over.
Not taking anything from anybody.
York Darkstorm puts up his dukes.
A little reversal there.
Oh, and a big back elbow. Darkstorm off the ropes. Oh, big leg lariat. Double forearms to the throat of Williams. What's Darkstorm going to be doing? What's he up to? Rolling thunder. Oh,
right in the mush.
Molasses.
Wait, now. No!
Darkstorm with the big belly to belly. He needs to go for a cover right now. Lay the wolf down for the count. 1, 2, 2.5. Aaron Williams kicks out.
Into the crossface.
Into the crossface. What? Can he survive this? Can Aaron Williams survive? It's for half the marbles. It's for the AIWF championship.
He's got his feet under the ropes. I mean, he's got to let it go.
Nathan Wolf breaks up the crossface.
That's what I like about Nathan Wolf, though. You know, we saw the aggressiveness towards Aaron Williams when he was aggressive towards him, but at the same time, he was no less aggressive towards Eric Darkstorm when Darkstorm was trying to work the count there on
right
that, on
down
that
the
crossface.
Oh, Williams drapes Darkstorm's third across the ropes. Now he's going back up to the top. He's climbing the ladder.
This part two here might not be what pays off for him now. Darkstorm's there. Yeah.
Darkstorm.
Big right in the noggin.
Kick right upside the head. Williams seems to be out of it, sitting on the top rope. Darkstorm is going to join him. What do we got here?
We got a dual occupancy in the high rent.
Uh-oh. Big Frankensteiner off the top.
Williams
rolls through. One, two, two and a half,
so
almost.
Close. So
almost
close.
Had him. Oh, the big kick upside the head.
He's going.
Williams.
Hey, pull out all Lord. The stops. Here
oh,
we go.
No.
Is this
oh, no. Oh, no.
Pile driver,
a big
baby.
Pile driver. It's 1987 all over again. Two. Oh, and he kicks out somehow.
2 5/8 even.
Somehow, Eric Darkstorm. Is he human?
Darkstorm's brains are scrambled from the pile driver.
Is there
Williams.
A Darkstorm from Asgard?
It's very possible. It's very possible. I don't know if he's from Asgard, but I mean, I bet Charles Xavier's at least had a conversation with him.
You're probably right.
His head's ringing from that pile driver. Williams is obviously showing the effects of that kick to the head from a few seconds ago.
Williams back up to his feet first. How is he going to put him away? Big kick to the midsection. He feeds him his fist in the corner. Big stomp.
Kick to the back of the head there.
We're being kind of quiet right now. We're just beside ourselves. We can't believe that Darkstorm kicked out.
That burst of action we had in just that sequence was ridiculous. And you can tell the toll's been taken on both these guys.
Well, it means so much to them for the AIWF championship.
The heart and passion is still there, but they're obviously both running on E right now. It's really who can pull out a big move next.
Darkstorm up.
Might be here.
Big forearm into the corner. Williams drags him out. Forearms, uppercuts, forearms.
One to the body there for good measure.
Down to his knees, Eric Darkstorm. Williams preening to the crowd, probably not a good idea.
Yeah, if you want to be the next champion, I don't think preening's the way to go about it, you know.
Darkstorm catches the kick. Summoning the power from the God of Thunder. Williams catches the kick. Oh, and a back fist.
Right there.
Oh,
right
super
in the
kick.
Mouth.
Super kick. Darkstorm off the rope. Oh, and he dodges the knee. Oh, and Darkstorm with the crossface right in the middle of the ring.
Middle of the ring, nowhere to go.
Can he reach the
ropes this time?
He rolls him over.
He's got it. He's got it locked in.
And
there
he's a tap out. Eric Darkstorm is victorious. I can't believe it. After everything he went through.
Talk about a hell of an opening match right there. For all things, the championship title.
I am convinced that Eric Darkstorm is not human.
I would be prone to agree with the end of that showing. This is hands down the most impressive showing I've seen out of Eric Darkstorm since the beginning of this company.